Hi, I'm Randy Backman.
I am Tal.
We are back.
We hope you're having a Merry Christmas season. Happy Hanukkah.
We're getting close.
And I'm wearing the Christmassiest thing that I have, which
you
is
are?
This. Well, this is a kind of blood red, and I have my green toque on. But next week,
we're going to have Santa hats.
We're going to doll it up a little bit more next week.
Next week will be Santa hats. We're going to do Christmas songs next week. Right?
Yes, and for this, we were going to go back and we were going to try to take out of some of our earlier broadcasts some of the most train wrecky songs that we've done, but it was too much hassle, so we just decided to do this live again, and we picked some of our favorite songs that we've done, which isn't to say that they were particularly well performed.
No.
But
we'll see how they go.
Dad's going to start.
East Coast girls are hip, I really dig those styles they wear. And the Southern girls, with the way they talk, they knock me out when I'm down there. The Midwest farmer's daughter really make you feel alright. And the Northern girls, with the way they kiss, they keep their boyfriends warm at night.
Mixed up on that one.
I thought
we were doing the ending first.
Well,
but
it would have been a 1 minute song if I didn't go back and try to do something else.
Yeah, we should have done some Freebird like guitar solos in that one.
Dick Dale surf solo.
I was saying earlier that I can never hear that song anymore without thinking of the David Lee Roth version. Every time it goes like, well, I dig them girls. That part. I always want to hear that.
Cool.
And,
he has a great bluegrass album.
David Lee Roth?
Yes. You got to look up David Lee Roth bluegrass. He does all these bluegrass hits. He does Van Halen hits with banjos and stuff. With a real bluegrass band, it's phenomenal.
Well,
you
I've heard
your jump. And
okay. Well, I've heard an AC/DC one of those, which is pretty good, but I've never heard that one. But that sounds pretty good. Okay. I chose this next one because on one of our broadcasts, we kind of started it impromptu and we didn't really play it that well. So I printed out the lyrics properly and we're going to give it a whirl tonight. It's an old Buddy Holly tune. I don't
old love song with an orchestra. It's just great when you listen to the record.
Ready?
Yeah.
Just you know why. Why you and I will by and by know true love waits. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know. Just you and I, no true love ways. Throughout the days, our true love ways will bring us joys to share with those who really care. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I, no true love ways.
Solo?
Sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I, no true love ways.
Did Buddy Holly write that, or Paul Anka?
Buddy Holly wrote that.
Oh, very cool.
I think it's one of the most beautiful love songs ever.
Yeah, it is. And everybody knows that run only gets played in the song once.
Really?
On sax. Yeah.
Oh.
It's played once. It's always in everyone's head every time it comes around.
Well, I wonder who orchestrated that. It was Norman Petty. No, is that his name?
Norman Petty.
Yeah. Norman Petty, who produced it. I don't know who orchestrated it, but it's just beautiful. Gorgeous. Okay, you want to do this?
Yeah, Steely Dan.
Should we bring in Coco?
No, yeah, bring in Coco.
Coco Motion.
Tambourine.
Three. This is another one we did in an earlier show.
As they drag you by your feet.
are you swearing, kicking bagels, that you're not a gambling man? Then you'll find you're back in Vegas with a handle in your hand. Your black cards can make you money, so they hide them when you're able. In the land of milk and honey, you must put them on the table. There you go, back, Jack, do it again.
Gamblers Anonymous. You go back, Jack, and do it again. Oh, we're going to rock out now.
Let's see if we can get through this one. And then we'll maybe take a
what
question.
What key is this train wreck in?
Well, I was thinking E, like,
okay.
How does it go? It's like G, D,
oh, yeah.
D, A.
Got it.
Three, four.
Somebody's gonna hurt someone before the night is through. Somebody's gonna come undone. There's nothing we can do. Everybody wants to touch somebody if it takes all night. Everybody wants to take a little chance, make it come out right.
Tonight, I know. It's gonna be a heartache tonight. Heartache tonight, I know.
too bad.
It's keep getting worse and worse. Okay, let's do a quick, couple of quick questions. Okay, so apologies. I can't remember if we've read some of these before. Our questions are all unorganized. So, Paul Bensouf, maybe Bensouf, we might have read this one already. Greetings from New Mexico. Jeff Healey is one of my favorite blues guitarists. I know that he made a posthumous appearance on Randy's Heavy Blues album, but did you get a chance to work with him while he was still with us?
Yes, and thank you for that question. My Heavy Blues album was a real special project for me, where I got a trio that was a girl drummer who drummed like Keith Moon, John Bonham, and a bass player who played like John Entwistle and Jack Bruce. And so I did this trio album and had special guests on it, seven great guest blues guitar players. And while I was getting Joe Bonamassa and Neil Young and other guys like that, Robert Randolph, Peter Frampton, the idea popped into my mind, why don't I get Jeff Healey? And I had done a show with Jeff Healey in Toronto, which I had recorded. And he was doing the B.B. King song Early in the Morning, which is one of his encores. And it was at Massey Hall. And I had the recording of that, and I never got around to mixing or even listening to it. So I asked his widow if I could do that. And she said, sure, go ahead and do that. And it was really cool. So I went and got Early in the Morning by him. It was in the key of G. I wrote a song around it. So when I did the song, his solo would fit perfectly in it. And so his solo was in that song. It's called Confessing to the Devil. And later on, it was his 50th birthday at Massey Hall. I mixed that track with his lead guitar very loud, put his guitar on the stage at Massey Hall in the middle, played the track to the track live with his drummer and his bass player. When his solo came, we just let the track go and left his black Strat there on the stand, and it played the whole solo. We left the stage, and the whole thing just got quiet. It was Jeff's guitar wailing to the rhythm track. Then the rhythm track faded out, and it was just him doing, he kind of does Hendrix ending sometime with a wang bar and everything, and did that. Everyone was crying and got a standing ovation. So totally love Jeff Healey. He's a really great friend of mine. You could Google me and him at the Academy of Music in London, Academy of Sound. We did Guitar Gently Weeps for about 20 minutes. It's very verklempt, tear-jerking.
Yeah. So a couple great things about Jeff from me, Paul. I was privileged to open for him one day.
Oh.
Yeah, so I played in Toronto, and he was on Next, and I never got a chance to meet him. But I was thinking as you were talking about an interview that I read, that I saw on YouTube with Ritchie Blackmore, and the guy says, who are your favorite guitarists? And he named Jeff Healey as one of his favorite guitarists.
Wow.
And so for the folks at home that don't know this, Jeff Healey was a blind guy from Toronto that played his guitar on his lap, and he would fret it like that and play it. I mean,
Play blues, and it was just incredible, like Hendrix, Stevie Ray Vaughan kind of blues, and a great singer.
And we didn't say hello to Coco yet. Hi, Coco.
Hi.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
Konbanwa.
Their Japanese are getting better.
How's it going?
I'm doing good.
Okay.
Thank you.
Got any anime or manga to tell us about this week?
I don't know.
New interests?
Attack on Titan was always good.
Okay, we'll take one more question, then we'll do another song. Kevin Fry says, what are your favorite songs to play, your own or others?
I make a lot of money playing my own songs. I've been lucky enough to have a bunch of hits, and people want to hear those all the time. But this has been a lot of fun for me with Tal doing... these are songs I never would have played in my life, like played like this, and kind of learned. So I think it's improved my chording. My singing. I'm singing songs I would never sing before, and I'm actually singing them on a mic. And that's why we have these train wrecks. I'm not really familiar doing this, but it is very enjoyable and a lot of fun. So I like doing it all. Mm-hmm. We're very lucky. Things shut down. We make our own music. Coco's been broadcasting us like this YouTube live, and we're doing pretty good.
I like playing Spanish songs.
Yeah, me too.
I like playing kind of mountainy bluegrassy songs, like any song that... Any song that's kind of like... Oh, you're singing an ugly. Yeah, we should do it. We should do kind of a hillbilly... show one day.
Yeah.
But anyway, any song that goes like that, I always like playing. So let's get back to songs, and we'll come back to the questions in a second. What do you got next for us, and why? Okay, why'd you pick this one?
I remember playing the song growing up. I remember Lenny Bro learning it. He said it was a really great jazz song to learn all the great jazz chords. And I remember I had the single, and then I found it was written by Tony Hatch, the guy who wrote Downtown for Bette Clark. Mm. And I wrote a lot of her hits, so it's really a cool song.
If you're feeling sad and lonely, there's a service on.
If I messed it up.
If you're feeling sad and lonely, there's a service I can render. I'm the one who loves you only. I can be so warm and tender. Call me. Don't be afraid, baby, call me. Maybe it's late, but just call me. Call me and I'll be around. When it seems your friends desert you, there's somebody thinking of you. I'm the one who never hurt you. Maybe that's because I love you. Call me. Maybe it's late, but just call me. Don't hesitate, baby, call me. Call me and I'll be around. Dog, don't forget me, cause if you let me, sad and lonely, there's a service I can render. Tell the one who loves you only, I will be so warm and tender. Call me, maybe it's late, but just call me. Don't hesitate, baby, call me. Call me and I'll be around.
One of those songs with no endings.
Okay. Well, this one is a special dedication to a friend of mine and Coco's, Kathy.
Hi, Kathy.
And we did Summertime Blues one day, and we sent that out to Kathy because she's a big Who fan, and so are we. So we're going to do Bargain off of Who's Next.
Which I thought was called Problem.
We were thinking of rewriting it, rewriting the lyrics.
He goes, I call that a bargain, the best I ever. I thought it was, I call that a problem, the best I ever had.
Yeah.
We were driving the car, and he said, we want to do Bargain. I said, I never heard of that.
This is a great song and a great album to listen to for aspiring kind of rock musicians, because it sounds so heavy. The whole album sounds so heavy. And then when you listen closely, there's an acoustic guitar on one side. It's hard panned. And then there's one heavy guitar, and it's on the left side. It's not even on both channels, and it's a Gretsch. It's this brand, except an electric guitar. It's a Gretsch through a Fender, and you listen to it, and the drums sound quite flat. When you listen to the whole thing, it sounds so heavy. When you listen closely, you can't quite figure out where the heaviness is, and it's a real lesson for all of these guys that are trying to do everything to make their song sounds heavy, and it doesn't work. It's like kind of counterintuitive. But anyway, so we're going to try Bargain. We've never played this one before.
You're going to lead.
Let's start.
I'm gladly lose me to find you. Gladly give up all I had to find you and suffer anything and be glad. I'd pay any price just to get you. I'd work all my life and I will.
ever had. The best I ever had. I gladly lose me to find you. I gladly give up all I got to catch you. Just to win you, surrender my good life for bad. To find you, I'm gonna drown in nuts on man. Call that a bargain, the best I ever had. The best I ever had. I sit looking round, I look at my face in the mirror. Oh man, I screwed it up. I know I'm worth nothing without you. And like one and one don't make one, one and one make one. Oh shoot, I screwed it up. For that free ride to me. I screwed it up, sorry. Okay, take a solo.
Something else. Bubba O'Reilly.
I screwed up the bridge on that, but what a great track that is.
Well, the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, just be shooting dice, and at the edge of
upon her, and the trouble soon began. And Leroy learned the lesson, messing money, the wife of a jealous man. Keep it going. Well, the two men took to fighting, and when they pulled him off the floor, Leroy looked like a jigsaw puzzle.
Jim Croce.
Okay.
Another question?
You want to? Should we? Let's see. We got. We only got three songs left.
Yeah, I got one.
Okay, well, I have an extra one if we run out of time.
Sure.
Okay. Okay. Couple other questions.
Sure.
Okay. David Lee's our friend says Randy, Revelstoke, British Columbia, a hill with no breaks. Does that ring a bell?
It rings a bell, and I don't know how you know about that, but way, way back in 67 or 8, I was with the Guess Who. We had a big bus that we bought from a bus lines in Manitoba. We painted it blue, like robin's egg blue, and we put the Guess Who on the side in white letters, which was really stupid. It was like an advertisement saying, break into this bus, it's full of musical instrument. We drove around this bus, and we were driving into Revelstoke, which if you've been through the BC Mountains, Revelstoke is this gigantic city in the middle of the valley. So you're in the mountains and you're coming down this steep grade. And it's all kind of what's called runoffs. There were, when your brakes burn out, like in your truck, you take this runoff. You go halfway up a hill and then back. And you, so you slow down, you wait till your brakes cool off. You take, so you have to come down this hill in increments, so to speak. Our bus does not have air brakes. It's got real old-fashioned brakes. And after we notice our speed is getting faster and faster. We notice this noise. And Jim Martin, who is our bus driver, he says, I can't stop the bus. We're going to go off the cliff. So when you're coming to the last turn into Revelstoke, there's like a full turn just like this, 90-degree turn just like that. And you got to slow down. There's all kinds of things. Slow, go slow, go slow. We're going to go off the bridge. We're just going to go off. And right below it is houses, like people are living there below it. So he says, we're going to have to jump. So this old bus of ours had like an arm you pulled that opened the door, and then there was an elbow that locked. So the door's locked open, and he says, okay, you guys have got to jump. So Jim Cale jumps out. He's our bass player. He jumps out. You hit the side of the—we're going like 50 miles an hour, 60 miles an hour. Meanwhile, the bus is smoking and stinking because he's trying to put on the brakes. He's trying to jam it into gear to stop it, so the engine will stop it. So Jim Cale jumps off the bus. I say, I'm not jumping without my Les Paul. I go and get my 59 Les Paul in the case, wrap it in my quilt. Gary Peterson, the drummer, jumps off. He lands in the shoulder and gets all cut up and bruised. And I'm about to jump off with my Les Paul, holding it in my arms. I figure, I don't care if I break my face. I got to hold on to this guitar. Yeah.
Death would be better than losing the Les Paul.
And just as I'm about to jump, this noise happens, and Jim Martin managed to pull into third gear. And so the engine stopped the bus. I didn't have to jump off, but our transmission fell out. And the bus was kind of like smoking on fire. The brakes were burnt out. So there's that bus at the side of the hill with basically 20 or 30 feet to go. And we would have gone off this cliff into a house.
How does David know that?
I don't know. I don't know how David knows. So people were like coming into Revelstoke to see us that night, pulling over to the side of the road saying, do you guys need a lift? So some guys had pickup trucks. We put all our gears out of the bus into the pickup truck. We went into the place and played the gig. Came back to our bus in the middle of the night. It was totally shot. We had to rent a van. We put our bus on a flatbed train and took it back to Winnipeg, and that's when we got a new bus. But I don't know how you know that, but that's
Okay, so we keep getting questions about the Head On album, BTO.
Yeah.
I think we read a couple last time. Klaus Sembach from Denmark says, please play something from my favorite album, Head On. And then James Dewar says, find out about love. That's on that record,
yeah,
right? So let's hear 45 seconds of that.
I haven't played this.
Yeah.
get me away from all this madness, as the situation changes day to day. I've been looking around the world to find the answer. I just got to find some time to get away. I get up, I get down. I see there's no use in hanging around. I just got to get back on my feet, find out about love. It was all double guitars, kind of like the Allman Brothers, and it was a fun song. I haven't thought of it and played it in 50 years since that.
You never know, like, some of these folks.
Amazing that you like it. Maybe we should, me and Tel should record some of BTL's album cuts that all you guys like that are on the album but never got on the radio a lot. So send us in a list of weird songs you'd like find out about somebody wants Shotgun Rider, Don't Let the Bruise Bring You Down, whatever you want. We'll do a little thing. We'll do a download for you guys or something. We'll do a whole show of train wrecks, of BTO train wrecks, that I really don't know.
All right, we're
going to do this. I love this.
Okay, let's try this.
Last night I dreamt of San Pedro, just like I'd never gone. I knew the song, young girl with eyes like the desert. It all seems like yesterday, not far away. Tropical, the island breeze, all of nature wild and free. This is where I long to be, La Isla Bonita. And when the samba played, the sun would set so high, right through my ears and sting my eye, to Spanish lullaby. I fell in love with San Pedro. Warm wind carried on the sea, he called to me. Te dije te amo. I prayed that the days would listen so fast. Tropical, the island breeze, all of nature wild and free. This is where I long to be, La Isla Bonita. And when the samba played, the sun would set so high, ring through my ears and sting my eye, to a Spanish lullaby. Yeah.
Hey, Bridge. I'll just play like A minor and E7 and you can solo again.
Thank you.
was terrible.
Where are we going?
Okay.
Last night I dreamt of San Pedro, just like I'd never gone. I knew the song. Young girl with eyes like the desert. It all seems like yesterday, not far away. Tropical, the island breeze, all in nature wild and free. This is where I long to be, La Isla Bonita. And when the samba plays, and when the sun's a they're through my eye. Your Spanish lullaby, your Spanish lullaby, your Spanish lullaby.
Okay.
Whoa.
All right.
Telepathic ending.
Okay. One more question.
All right.
Get into our last couple. Would you consider coming to Muskoka and playing at the Key in Bala? Say, saw Randy and Burton play there back in the 80s. It was awesome.
I absolutely love the Key to Bala. You met Steve Strongman there.
That's right.
We played there. You,
that's right.
Yeah.
I've
played there a lot of times. And we'd come there. Tell the guy to give me a call. Just like you got a hold of me, tell him to get a hold of me. As soon as we can travel, we've got invites to go everywhere around the world.
Okay, last question for the night. Steve Whitehouse says, is there a guitar? I think I would remember if I asked this one before. Is there a guitar that you've always coveted but have never found?
Well, my Gretsch that was stolen in 1975, we found that after 50 years. It's in Japan. We're waiting so we can travel and get it. We found a guy named Takeshi. He's got the guitar. He agrees it's mine. I had to get one exactly like it to replace it. So it's 1957, 6120 Gretsch with the Armin pickups. Got a beautiful one. We're going to do a documentary on that called Guitar Highway on my lost guitar. But there's another one that was a Stratocaster that it was a black Strat and I stripped all the paint off it. It's got a T on it with an eagle holding a T that became the BTO logo. And on that guitar, I had a Tele pickup at the bridge, a Strat in the middle, and I switched between a Rickenbacker and a Gibson at the neck. That was my Brave Belt BTO Strat, even in the Guess Who, and somebody stole it from my garage when I lived in White Rock. I'd love to get that back. My initials are on it, RCB in little white scratch on letters and the big teeth eagles on it with the, and the headstock is split. It used to be a 9-string, so there's 3 extra holes in the headstock where they had an extra 3 strings on, and the headstock is split because I threw it into my amp trying to be like Pete Townsend.
Okay. Well, we just discovered, as far as I'm concerned, it would be pretty cool to get that Gretsch Roundup that just came available. But now, yes. I think it's now up to $28,000, so I don't think I'm going to be getting that. Do you want to do that, and then one more?
Sure.
Okay. All right. Okay, this one, thanks for joining us, Coco. You can join in on this one if you want.
Sure.
And this is a Selena Gomez song, and we'll never forgive Justin for what he did to Selena.
Which
Justin,
was what?
Justin Bieber.
What did he do?
He toyed with her. Laura's terrible. Oh. Okay, so this is a Selena Gomez song. We like this one.
It's been said and done. Every beautiful thought's been already sung. And I guess right now. Of them. You are beautiful, like a dream come alive, incredible, a sinful miracle, lyrical, you saved my life again, and I want you to know, baby, I love you like a love song, baby, I love you like a love song, baby, I love you like a love song, baby. Destiny, you are magical, lyrical, beautiful.
love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I keep it and repeat, beep, 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 beep. I love you like a love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I keep it in repeat, beep, 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 beep. Last time. I love you like a love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I love you like a love song, baby. I keep it in repeat, beep, 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 beep. Heat up, I cool down. And the wheels go spinning now. Abra, abra, get down.
What's another song?
Gloria Gaynor.
There's another song. Once I was alone, I was terrified. Deep thinking I could never live without you by my side.
Yeah.
Yeah, I spent so many nights thinking how you done me wrong, and I grew strong. Change the super locks. Should have loved a little love. If I know for just one moment you'd be back to bother me, I'm gonna go on out the door. Turn around now. You're not welcome anymore. Aren't you the one that tried to stumble? You're still lay down and die. You're not
alone. I will survive. Kind of a neat medley train wreck.
That's on the Rocky theme.
Is it?
I think so. Anyway. Okay, let's do that.
Okay.
All right. Midnight Oil. Australia.
Out where the river broke, the budding wood and desert oak, golden rocks and boiling diesel, 45 degrees. The time has come to say fair's fair, to pay the rent, to pay our share. The time has come. Lives and breathes in 45 days.
Facts are facts.
We got one more song.
One more song. Let's rock out.
Thank you for joining us. And
those are our greatest hits.
No matter what happens in this crazy topsy-turvy world, we'll always be here on a Friday night. Oh. Friday night train wrecks.
And we always have rock and roll.
That's right.
We rock, and next week is Christmas rock.
Next week we're going to be doing Christmas songs. And please push like and subscribe and then share with your friends. And anything else?
Well, if you got a radio, turn on Randy's Vinyl Tap, CBC One, on Saturday night.
That's right. Yeah.
And that's on again Sunday on Radio 2 at 6 o'clock.
And then Sirius XM, we have our Beatles show, Musical Mystery Tour.
And this month, the show is on Middle Eights. And a lot of guys are sending in emails saying they never knew what a middle eight was, which is, or the bridge in the middle of the Beatles song. So we're getting through to some guys.
Yeah, so we're breaking down Beatles songs for musicians and non-musicians alike. Once again, we send our best wishes out to Kathy and all of her friends and family. And we'll wrap this up with maybe the greatest rock riff of all time.
And I don't mean American Woman.
I'm so out of tune.
With a few red lights and a few old beds, you
the world's greatest guitar riff and the worst lyrics I've ever heard.
I mean,
in verses, they are absolutely.
It sounds
like ABBA wrote them. ABBA wrote better lyrics.
Way
than that.
Better. No, this is like a weird little kid wrote them in like 5 minutes.
Yeah, like grade two.
And yet,
see Spot Run.
And yet, a great melody or a great riff covers a multitude of lyrical sins. It's the strangest thing.
Tell us about
these,
it.
Yeah. Anyway, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. See you next week, Christmas week.
And we'll be back next week.
Thanks, Erico.
Thank you, Coco.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Time for dinner.